Learn to pray, though faith arrived me along the way. The sun is shining for me each day. I found the answer. I learned, everybody's standing. I found the answer. I've learned to pray, with faith arrived me along the way. The sun is shining. Your neighbor and say, neighbor, victory's waiting for you to knock on his door. So we're going to see what the scripture says. Hallelujah. My reader is gone. My alternate is gone. So Elder Cunningham and I guess are going to do a tag team today. This is about your second or third time, but I need you to preach it to me. Hallelujah. Touch your neighbor and say, preach Elder Cunningham.
Preach Elder Cunningham.
Philippians chapter number 4 is where we are. Hold up. Thank God Mother Stevenson's in the house this morning. Hallelujah. The enemy tried to afflict her with the flu. Amen. But she's here today. Amen. Hallelujah. Back to the community. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God. Philippians chapter 4, verse number 1.
Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved and long for my joy and crown, so stand fast in the Lord.
Stand fast in the Lord.
My dearly beloved.
My beloved.
I beseech ye, Otis.
I'm trying to tell you, Eulia.
And beseech Cynthia. That the be the same, but be of the same mind.
Y'all gotta come together, yes?
And I entreat thee also. True yoke fellow.
Yes.
Help those women.
Help the women around here.
Which labored with
they doing too much work. Help them out. Yes. Come on.
And with other my fellow laborers.
Yes.
Whose names are in the book of life.
They in the book of touch your neighbor if you're a woman in here and say, I'm in the book of life. You can put me out of your book, but I'm in the book of life. Rejoice.
Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand.
The Lord is at hand.
Be careful for nothing.
Don't be anxious for anything.
But in everything by prayer.
But in everything you got to do it by prayer.
With thanksgiving.
And supplication. nation with thanksgiving.
Let your requests be made known.
Touch your neighbor and say, all you got to do is tell God. Uh-huh.
And the peace of God.
Uh-huh.
Which passes all my mind.
Telling God. Going to rest. Father, we thank you for this word. We pray, God, now in the name of the Lord, that you would be with us in Jesus' name. Speak this word to us. In the name of the Lord, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Take your seats in the presence of the Lord. We got to preach this thing and move on. Hallelujah. So, we are again in this particular series where we're going after the power of God.
After the power of God.
And we are picking up some stuff that we've lost. Stuff ain't been taught in church like it ought to be taught in church. Neither is it applied or appreciated in church like it ought to be appreciated in church. We would come, hallelujah, for a $1 million service before we would come to a prayer meeting.
Right.
We got to touch your neighbor and say, we got to go back. To some degree, a lot of times when we stand behind this desk and we lead prayer, rather if we get down on our knees, a lot of times we don't even recognize the power behind what we are doing. We literally go to God and we tell God, and when we get up off our knees, we don't expect him to do it just like we ask him to do it. Moreover than that, we're not expecting more than what we allowed to come off of our lips. We go to God as if he is another person, but he's not another person. Hallelujah. He's a bigger power. Touch your neighbor and say, he's another power. Y'all ain't talking in here today. And so we have been in this series in which we cannot forget why we do what we do. Neither can we throw away those things that we are supposed to throw away. We went back to communion and we talked about the power of the blood. And then we talked about obeying and keeping the Sabbath. We moved on last week and we expressed that there is a third dimension of baptism. It is water. There is fire. There is water. There is Holy Ghost. And then there is fire. Y'all ain't talking in here today. If I'm fire baptized, ain't nothing gonna be able to stop me from doing what God has called me to do. I've got an everlasting passion and everlasting conviction that allow me to get through any circumstance or dilemma that I'm in. And so here we are today looking at an important secret as we discover the secret place, the sacred place, and that is the power of prayer. Touch your neighbor and say, the power of prayer. Where I come from, they used to tell us that we ought to learn how to not just praise through, but we ought to learn how to pray through. Y'all ain't talking here. We got to learn how to pray through any circumstance that we're going through. Pray through what's going on our jobs. Pray through the hell that we got to look at in our homes. Pray through the situation or the circumstance that plagues my mind. We got to pray through to get the Holy Ghost. We got to pray through to get power. Y'all ain't talking in here today. Such a neighbor said, you got to learn how to pray through. There's some stuff that half of us are crying over or laughing about. But you got to learn how to stop crying about everything and learn how to pray through. Such a neighbor say, pray through that. You got to learn that you got power over what you're going to deal with when you leave Christ Connected Community this morning. You got power over the supervisor that you got to look at in the face on Monday morning. You got power over the bank account. You got power over the economic system. You got power in your bank. Y'all ain't talking in here today. It ain't that money that dictates the course of your life. You got to learn how to pray through and get through, and God will take you there. Touch your neighbor and say, pray through. So here as we continue this series, we turn our attention to the book of Philippians.